Physician is the best prover. Okay, physician is the best prover. We have to, though, we will see this. Physician is the best prover because of the following advantage. What is the advantage? One is the physician is a literate person. He know the medical words, languages. Okay, the physician know when the great certainty in the things he has experienced in the own person. 141. Okay, aphorism number 141. It is given. Okay. When the physician proves a medicine upon himself, then any uncertainty in respect of exact changes in health are entirely removed. Okay, it is just like any disease. Okay, if you have you yourself has experienced any disease, okay, like cough, cold, fever, okay, you will understand better. Okay, suppose your patient will tell you, sir, I am sneezing, then you will just ask, there is pain in the root of no this root of nose. Okay, then frontal headache is there, then your patient will tell yes. Okay, so like that. Okay, so if physician himself experience the things, okay, so it is more better. Okay, it means he can explain the things better and he can understand the exact action of the drugs. Okay, like for me, if any homeopathic medicines I have taken and I have got that result, okay, for anything, okay, like it may be fever, it may be cough, cold, it may be diarrhea, okay, I am more confident about that particular drugs. Okay, it happens. Okay, so this is like that. What you have studied, okay, that is different thing, but what medicine you took and you got relief, okay, that medicines give you more confident when you are prescribing. Okay, so the physician know when the greatest certainty in the things he has experienced in the own person, aphorism number 141. Then the physician proves a medicine upon himself when any uncertainty in the respect of exact changes in health are entirely removed. The medicinal qualities of the drugs lies in the changes of the health has been himself undergone. From the medicine he can proved and the morbid state he has himself experienced from them, because for him an incontrovertible fact. Okay, means it is like that. If you any medicine you have experienced on yourself, okay, when you have taken any cases of disease, or when you have just taken, when you are doing any drug proving, okay, so you know all the facts and that's why you are more bold or more confident about that particular drug. Okay, it is given in aphorism number 141, aphorism number footnote 1. Okay, so it happens. Okay, anything we have experienced in our life, okay, that is for that we are more confident or more there is no controversy on that. Okay, so like that. By such noteworthy self-observation, the physician will himself be trained to be what every physician ought to be, a good observer. Okay, the physician should be also a good observer. Okay, any type of change he or she is feeling, they have to properly note in their record book, or that is called as a also day diary. Okay, these experiments on himself promises to give him a reliable knowledge of the true values and significance of the instruments of cure that are still to be great degree unknown to our great art. Okay, our great art is that homeopathy. Okay, homeopathic art. So this is unknown. This experience on himself promises give him a reliable knowledge of the true value and significance of the instruments of the cure that are still to a great degree unknown to our art. Okay, means if you have a better experience of things, you can just explain that particular things very boldly and very confidently. Okay, it is given in aphorism number 141, footnote 1 again. Okay, then we will go to next part. Well-conducted drug proving never produces any injurious effect on the health or the prover. On the contrary, experience shows that the body of a prover become more resistant to the disease by removing the external morbid influences. His health more robust, moreover, immense power and great increase against all the kind of infection. Aphorism number 141, footnote footnote one. Okay, it is just like a vaccination. Okay, you have not got COVID-19, but still you took vaccine and you got COVID-like symptom. Okay, now your body is more resistant to COVID. Okay, today just one news was coming. Okay, that somewhere exactly I was not able to hear that particular thing. Okay, when I was just listening the news. Okay, so okay, some research have done. Okay, and this research. Okay, actually where it was done, I couldn't listen. Okay, so in research they found ki who has taken COVID vaccine. Okay, they are not getting any severe disease. Okay, and I think they have done this in 3,000 or more than 3,000 patient. Okay, COVID patient, and they got result ki who have already taken COVID vaccine, they have not got become serious. Okay, they have not got serious, and nobody of them have died. Okay, so this. Was there. Okay, so I think in future this type of this research will also come out ki exactly what is till now. To it was exactly there was no figure na ki pupils are just saying, and some research of authorities they are telling only ki like who have taken COVID vaccine they are not like getting severe, and they are not symptoms are not complicated, but the data of dying or not dying was not there. Okay, patients who have taken who have already got COVID, they also second time also they got COVID. Okay, but the death exactly about the death nobody was telling. Okay, so this was this simple one research that was in news. Okay, so I think in future we can expect more this type of news. Okay, so like that ki always there is, if you are doing a drug proving on him yourself or any type of proving is there, healthy proving. Okay, properly proved drug. Okay, so I think it is more better to get you will get the better result, and you will feel the action of drug in better way. Okay, then next part is precautions to be taken during proving. Okay, what precautions we have to take. Okay, that is important. Okay, regarding the medicine. Okay, always we know ki medicine should be of genuine quality. Okay, otherwise everything will be going vain. Okay, everything is wasted. Okay, the medicines to be proven must be well known, and its purity, genuineness, and the energy are to be thoroughly assured. Okay, aphorism number 122, 122. It must be taken in a perfectly simple unadulterated form. Okay, the medicine should not be in adulterated form. Okay, what is the meaning of adulteration? Mixing up of. I just gave example of that brick. Okay, ki like just this chili powder. Okay, red chili powder. Sometimes bricks are added to just increase its weight. Okay, so that the person can earn more benefit or more money. Okay, brick, because brick powders are one brick near normally comes by 1 rupees, 2 rupees, 3 rupees, 5 rupees. Okay, and so that's why one brick can give you a lot of powder. Okay, so like that, so that's why they do this type of adulteration. Okay, so it must be taken in a perfectly simple unadulterated form. Okay, aphorism number 123. Every medicine substances must be taken quite alone and perfectly pure. Okay, quite alone and perfectly pure. Okay, medicine should be taken single medicine. Okay, otherwise you will not understand the practical use of that medicine. Okay, so quite alone and it should be perfectly pure. Aphorism number 124. Okay, then only one drug should be proved at a time. Already we have discussed about that, because the individual properties of the particular drug will be known. Okay, so that you can, when anybody will ask in why we should take a single drug. Okay, so the reason behind this is a single drug will give a proper quantity of proper way of identification of that particular disease, and you can just confirm with your investigations and the cure. Okay, there will be no mixture of the symptomatology of the different drugs with suspicion of the sequel order of their appearance. Okay, then the medicines must not be given for several successive days. Okay, already this also we have discussed that medicine should not be given for a long time. Okay, it should be given for a short period of time or what is the recommended period of time. Otherwise, it may just put some harmful effect in our body. Okay, that there will be irreversible pathology. Okay. Then the medicine must not be given for several successive days in over increased doses as too frequent repetition confuse the symptom. Aphorism number 131. Okay, we are near to aphorism number 145 because this drug proving is from aphorism number 105 to 145. So till 131 already we reached. Okay. Next is fifth is administration of the larger doses of the medicine should be avoided as they bring out secondary infections, but hurried appearance of the primary symptoms unsuitable for the study. Okay, this is given in aphorism number 137. Okay, the administration of large doses of the medicine should be avoided as bring out the secondary reaction. Okay, means large doses may sometimes there will be reaction and there will be overreaction. Okay, so that may be that secondary reaction, primary or secondary reaction, I think you have studied. Okay, and if you have not studied, you will study in Organon of Medicine. Like some, it is just you can understand these things. Okay, the simple way of primary and secondary reaction. Okay, the primary reaction, suppose a honeybee will bite you. Okay, so suddenly you will just take your hands leg. This is the primary reaction. Hands back, this is primary reaction. After sometimes that area will be swollen, that is the secondary reaction of your body. Okay, so that's why. Okay, next is the dietary restrictions, aphorism number 125. During the whole period of experiments, the diet of the prover must be restricted regularly. Okay, means diet should be properly restricted. Then nature of the diet. Diet during proving should be purely nutritious and simple. Okay, diet should be about the diet already we know. Okay, aphorism number 125. Okay, the diet should be pure. It should not be more salty, more sweet, more spicy. Okay, it should be just a general. Okay, very simple diet. Okay, vegetable all out, very green peas, green French beans, carrots. Okay, avoid green vegetables, roots, all salads, herbs, soups and spices. Okay, I don't know why they are telling ki just green vegetables, roots, salads. Okay, they are thinking ki some salads and roots there that may have some medicinal value in crude form also. That may be a reason. Okay, otherwise though I am little like confused with this, why they are telling to avoid this. Okay, because just this may be a reason, some of the salads, roots and all these things have medicinal values. Okay, that's why they are telling you just to avoid this. Okay, then next is the beverage. Okay, beverage already know, tea, coffee, alcohol must be avoided by the prover during proving experiments. Okay, I think when you have taken COVID vaccine also, at that time when particular nursing staff who has given you COVID vaccine, he or she has explained to you ki don't take any type of alcohol or beverage for at least 48 hours. Okay, so like that, so just this should be avoided. Okay, it means tea, coffee or beverage should be avoided. Okay, then mental restrictions, aphorism number 126. Okay, aphorism number 126, mental restrictions, what mental activity you should not do. Okay, he must avoid all over exertions of the mind and body, all sorts of dissipations and disturbance. Okay, passions, all these things. Okay, means over exertions of mind should be avoided. There should not be any type of work pressure, any type of family pressures, mental harassment, anything should not be there. Okay, person should be calm and quiet. Okay, like that. Okay, means mentally healthy. Okay, then he should have no urgent business to distract his attention. Okay, means there should not be any work, urgent work or anything should not be there. Okay, then there should be he must possess a sufficient amount of the intelligence to be able to express and describe his sensation in accurate term. Okay, means person should be a properly and general common sensation should be there so that he can explain everything properly and in general way. Okay, so he must not himself be careful observation and not be disturbed whilst or engaged. Okay, means the person himself should also be honest so that he should not engage himself in just any type of trouble or any type of mental exertions like that. Okay, when can a medicine be considered to be have been thoroughly proved? That is very much important. Okay, this question was asked many times, mainly in PG this question is asked. Okay, ki, or sometimes nowadays are asked in UG also. Okay, ki, when can a practice medicine be considered to have been thoroughly proved? Okay, means when you can tell ki your medicine is thoroughly or properly proved. Okay, so when can a medicine can be considered to be a thoroughly or properly proved? First, okay, what a medicine can be considered to have been thoroughly proved in the following condition, it is given in aphorism number 135. What are the reasons? Okay, first, it must be proved on suitable person of both sexes and of the various constitution. Okay, means when we have done the process of drug proving on the both the sexes of all the age group and various constitution from pediatrics to geriatrics. Okay, means pediatrics, adults and old persons. Okay, everywhere we have done the proving, then it is first condition is it is called as your drug proving is completed. Okay, second, subsequent experiments can notice little of a novel character from the action. Okay, means when you are doing repeatedly you are doing the proving and you are not getting any new symptom. What your symptom when your first time you have done proving? Okay, already you got same symptom second times. Okay, except little changes, very little changes. Okay, subsequent experiments can noticed. Okay, little of the novel character from the action. Okay, very little changes are there. Okay, means main characters are there, only very little changes are there. Any more symptom, very little, not significant symptom, then you can tell ki your drug proving is completed. Next is the almost always the same symptom as had already been observed by other are exhibited during reproving. Reproving means it is same thing. Okay, what you are doing the drug proving, same work you are doing on other healthy person. This is called as a reproving. Okay, sometimes questions come, what is the process or protocol for reproving? The one line answer is it is same as the first proving. But if it comes as a long question, you have to explain the process of drug proving itself in a large way. Okay, in a proper way. Okay, so it is nothing else, just it is a all the process of drug proving is conducted second time, third time. Okay, this is called as a reproving. Okay, the symptoms must carefully recorded are complete with regards to their specific sensation, location, modalities, and concomitant factor so that a complete individual picture of the drug has been established. Okay, now here four terms came. The symptoms must carefully recorded or completed with the regard to their specific sensation. Sensation. Okay, first is sensation. Okay, like I am feeling fever. Sensation. Okay, then suppose I am feeling headache. Okay, then location is head. Okay, headache. Then modality is okay, amelioration by pressing, aggravation by okay, stress. Okay, or like doing some work. Okay, and concomitant with headache, I have like some other problems. Okay, like I'm getting vertigo. Okay, so this okay, this, about this you will know better in case taking when you will study in second year. Okay, case take about okay, way of case taking, how to take the case. Okay, the location, sensation, modalities, concomitant, these are the four factors. Okay, remember this. Okay, so that a complete, this is called as a parts of complete symptoms, any symptoms which have all these four factors, sensation, location, modalities, and concomitant. Okay, this is called as a complete symptoms or complete symptoms of an individual. Okay, picture of the drug has been established. Okay. Then next we will go clinical verification and has not exhibited any clinical symptom even after repeating. Okay. Now, what is clinical symptom? Suppose after drug proving drug you have given to your patient as a prescription, but after sometimes 1 year, 2 year, you got some notice when I am giving this drug, this patient is telling this type of symptom, and it is not only in 5 or 10 patients, it should be more than 100, 200 patients. Okay, then this is called as a clinical symptoms. You got any symptom in your clinic that is not recorded in during drug proving in your Materia Medica. Okay, that is called as a clinical symptom. Okay, so remember this clinical symptom. Next is the relative demerits and merits of employing large and moderate doses. Okay, what is the use of applying large doses and what is the means demerits or loss of applying large doses? Demerits of employing excessive large doses. Already we have talked about this. It may have a toxic effect. The toxic and poisonous effect of the drug may be developed. Okay, the toxic or poisonous effect of the drug may be toxic or poisonous effect of the drug may be there. Okay, the toxic and poisonous effect of the drug may be developed. Okay, so that is important. The toxic and the poisonous effect of the drug may be developed. Okay, second is the primary action of the medicine will be appear in such hurried and confusion. Okay, means when primary action, okay, means when you are giving a large dose, okay, you will not understand about the primary action of the medicine, will appear in a such a hurried confusion, okay, because of the confusion. Okay, then next part is when such violence that nothing can be accurate observed. Okay, the symptoms of the primary action will get mixed up with the secondary action. Okay, the action of the primary action will be mixed with the action of the secondary action. Okay, then the drugs produce different types of symptoms in different doses. Okay, drugs produces different type of symptoms in the different type of doses. Okay, that's why that is also a large quantity of dose may causes a problem. Okay, means you have to study properly the poisonous effect of the drugs. Okay, poisonous or the adverse effect of the drug, and after that only. Okay, in large doses the medicine produces the physical action that is called as a chemical action or a physiological action. Okay, so that is appears. Okay, that physiological or chemical actions that appears. Okay, then in small doses the medicine produces to all the members of the certain classes of the drugs. Okay, it happens. Okay, in the small doses it just give a generic effect. Okay, then in very small doses this produces a specific action which manifests the characteristic symptoms of the medicine. Okay, means very small dose they just give a specific or proper action of the drug. Okay, then merits of employing moderate doses. What is the merit of applying moderate doses? Okay, the symptoms of the medicine's actions are more distinctly observed. Okay, the symptoms of the primary symptom of the medicine is distinctly observed, occurs without any administration of the symptoms, secondary actions or reaction of the viral vital force. Okay, vital force already we have discussed. Okay, okay. This about this you will study better in organ of medicine. Okay, other sources besides drug proving to know the accurate properties of the drug. Drug proving is the only reliable sources known for the curative properties of the drug, but however we can acquire knowledge about the drug some extent through, okay, like history of poisoning, narcotic of any toxic drugs. Okay, then empirical sources are like already we are just learning some chemical sources. Okay, already we are learning some chemical sources or other sources that is called as empirical sources. Then chemistry, then deep and all round. Okay, Biochemistry, okay. Then these, then explanations, okay. Explanation poisoning of, okay. The symptoms collected from the cases of poisoning has been a immense value. Those have great curative power. Those are occupied in the material. Materia medica as a clinical symptoms. This gives information about the sphere of action, chemical action, and common symptoms of the drug. Even poisonous substances, when used in a minute quantity, produces finer symptoms. The knowledge of the toxic effect of the substances helps in the identification of the power of the drug, but not in obtaining complete knowledge of the curative power of it. Many dreadful poisons like Lachesis, Crotalus is there, other snake poisons, arsenic, okay, Stramonium, okay, Crotontigue are found, okay, to be the useful homeopathic medicines when they are given in their toxic and symptoms to minute doses. Then empirical, okay, empirical or empirical knowledge gives only superficial views and did not helps in acquiring the complete and rational knowledge about the curative power of the drug. Okay, then chemistry. From the chemistry, we got the general information about the authority, standards, and action principle of the drug, chemical action of a drug in different forms, its dynamic action, chemical actions, then produces only the common symptoms of the medicines, but it does not gives a knowledge about the dynamic properties of the drug. Okay, then chemical properties are there. Then biochemistry, it gives information about the biochemical actions of the drug. Okay, related with biochemistry, biochemical action of the drug. Okay, then drug one or two system of the organ. Okay, then as results, this knowledge is suitable only for the relative treatment. In homeopathy, only a few drugs have been induced because of their biochemical action. Okay, so in homeopathy, it is not so much there, but only biochemical action of some drug is only given. Okay, research on drug proving. Okay, what are the research on drug proving? Okay, what research going on? Okay, this is just not at UG level. I don't feel so much important, but just we will go through it, okay, little, so that you have some matter, okay, to write in your theoretical papers. Okay, proving of new drug, proving or antibiotic, steroids, and other modern drugs should be, means there is proving of some modern drug, steroids. Okay, all these things also should be. Then over healthy human being in a potentized form. Okay, means any steroid, anything modern medicine you are using, first you have to potentize as per our potentization method or trituration method or secretion method, then you can use it. Okay, to get many valuable data, these drugs may be effective in certain many other obstinate and complicated chronic diseases. When well-selected medicines fail to effect in countries like chloramphenicol is there, okay, cured the patient in vertigo, possesses symptoms and very useful. Okay, then equality roots results in observed from the aspirin in acute migraine headaches. Okay, so we should get this fully picture of these drugs. Okay, so like some allopathic drugs are there. Okay, so that drugs, okay, you can potentize properly and you can use so that you can give the drug pictures. Okay, because you have many literatures related with the allopathic drugs, because they are just curing the medicine in their the patient in their material doses. Okay, the aspirin is there. Aspirin acts migraines, headaches. So we should get the fully covered picture of these. Okay, then isotes group in drugs. Okay, like aspirin, when you take a large quantity, it may just causes sometimes, okay, as a cerebral hemorrhage also. Okay, because they just dilate the capillaries of our body. Okay, and it just dilute the blood. Okay, then if we get full picture of these drugs, okay, then steroids, okay, we can easily combine the drugs and diseases combined from the allopathic system. Okay, so this is like that. Okay, already you have drug pictures and many things, that by that you can do drug proving and you can just get the things. Okay, proving and reproving of the NOSODs and SARCODs, this is also going on in the research basis. Okay, the NOSODs and SARCODs, okay, which are not proved at all. Okay, because NOSODs and SARCODs already we know ki healthy secretion and disease secretions are there. Okay, so sometimes to NOSOD to disease secretion already we get some symptoms. Okay, so like that. That's why properly these are not proved before. Okay, so for that reprovings are going on. The NOSODs and SARCODs have a great role in during the chronic complications and incurable diseases, even in acute disease, complete cure in uncertainly delayed. Okay, unless a dose of the indicated NOSODs administered. Okay, the drug like the thyrodimine, okay, insulin, okay, then lysine is there, okay, then X-ray is there, has been NOSODs, okay, requires properly proving of or there. Okay, then next we will see next part is proving on lower animals. Okay, how to, okay, these things are also going on the research basis. Drug proving on lower animals. Okay, homeopathic drug proving is not confirmed up by stage of the organic characters on the healthy human beings because it may be hazardous or the life threatening. Okay, so first it is proved in the lower animals. Okay, organic changes and everything is just seen. Okay, now we will just go through one difference is there. Okay, what is that difference? Okay, difference between the fully proven drug and partially proven drug. Okay, yeah, how the drugs are fully proven, how they are the partially proven drugs are there. Okay, methods. Hahnemann methods of drug proving of a medicine is called as a fully proven drug. Okay, then partially proven toxicological, empirical, clinical observations, these are called as a partially proven. Okay, when any drug is just proved partial. Okay, like all these things are called as a partially proven drugs. Okay, means which literature we have got, but homeopathically they have not proved. Okay, symptoms, wide range of symptoms we have when we proved fully. Okay, partially proved, short range of symptoms are there. Okay, pathogenesis, specific, dynamic. Okay, then beginning to the cause and idiosyncratic patients. Okay, specific only. Okay, pathogenesis is specific and partially proven. Okay, then like what literature you will get. Okay, about already all these drugs are going on. Okay, that may be Unani, Ayurveda, allopathy. Okay, so these are like a partially proven. When we only tell fully proven for ourselves, when we just prove that particular drug homeopathically. Okay, then complete compositions of the symptoms. Okay, general keynote. Okay, then particular and causes. Okay, guiding symptoms and causes. Okay, then actions, deep and all around. Okay, then superficial. Okay, then partially alters and secondary action, partially local. Okay, focal and general actions. Okay, then next is the relationship with other remedies. Okay, no relationship with other remedies. Okay, about relationship of remedies we will learn. Okay, when we will study drug, medicine and remedy. Okay, at that time. Now little sketch is there, sources of drug knowledges. Okay, about the drug proving. Okay, everything is given. Okay, with this is just chart to understand. Okay, when you will going for exam. Okay, at that time you can see this chart. Okay, so like drug proving aphorism number 105 to 145. Okay, this is individualization is there, definition is there. Okay, prerequisition is there, rules are there. Okay, then other is poisoning is there, empirical is there, chemistry is there, biochemistry is there. Okay, then selection of a prover, animal proving is there. Okay, then human proving is there. Methods of preparation of the drugs, aphorism number 123, it is given. Okay, so all the aphorisms are properly explained. Okay, nearby, not properly, nearby. Okay, explained all the aphorisms. Okay, then indigenous plants, exotic substances, salts and gums. Okay, dry and weak medicines. Okay, then here we will see in person aphorism number 107, on healthy individual 108. Okay, so like that it is given. Okay, actually it is the explanation of each aphorism is given. Okay, then on healthy individuals. Okay, qualities. Okay, ideal prover, best prover, idiosyncratic prover. क्रोनिक प्रूवर ओके बोथ सेक्सेस फॉर एग्जाम्पल नंबर 135 इन डिफरेंट एज ग्रुप डिफरेंट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस ओके देन मेनी पर्सन्स 134 दिस इज जस्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द एफोरिजम्स ओके मेनली व्हिच एफोरिज्म व्हाट इज गिवन ओके देन वीक मेडिसिन्स एफोरिज्म नंबर 121 मोड ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन 128 ओके मोर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन 129 ओके प्रूविंग ऑन स्मॉल डोजेस ओके देन मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स ऑफ मॉडरेट एंड लार्ज डोजेस 112 137 ओके देन रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ सिम्टम इज देयर ओके प्रिकॉशंस इज देयर ओके देन रिगार्डिंग मेडिसिन ओके क्वालिटीज ऑफ द मेडिसिन एफोरिज्म नंबर 122 टू 124 ओके देन मेडिसिन डोज 131 टू 137 ओके देन मेडिसिनल 124 देन मेंटल 126 ओके देन डायट्रिक 125 देन सिम्टम्स बाय रिकॉर्डेड के हाउ सिम्टम्स आर रिकॉर्डेड ओके दैट मीन्स सिम्टम्स ऑफ रिकॉर्डेड ओके देन एक्सेप्ट नार्कोटिक्स गिवन इन 114 एफोरिज्म नार्कोटिक्स 113 एफोरिज्म अल्टरनेटिंग एक्शन 115 एफोरिज्म ओके मॉडलिटीज 133 एफोरिज्म एनी अल्टरनेशन फ्रॉम नॉर्मल हेल्थ 138 एफोरिज्म ओके देन प्रूविंग ऑन सिक पर्सन एफोरिज्म नंबर 142 फुटनोट 2 ओके एंड हाउ टू डाउन अप हाउ टू राइट डाउन अबाउट द अबव सिम्टम्स लिटरेट प्रूवर 139 एफोरिज्म इलिटरेट प्रूवर 140 एफोरिज्म फिजिशियन हिमसेल्फ इज ए प्रूवर एफोरिज्म नंबर 141 रिमेंबर दिस ओके फिजिशियन हिमसेल्फ इज ए प्रूवर 141 ओके मेनी टाइम दिस इज आस्क्ड इन कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स ओके देन नेक्स्ट वी विल गो ओके दिस इज जस्ट अबाउट द एफोरिज्म्स ओके इफ यू विल रिमेंबर इट इज वेल एंड गुड ओके इफ यू विल नॉट रिमेंबर ओके इट विल बी